Welcome, graduates, parents, family, friends, and faculty. We are here to celebrate the class of 2021. Their senior prank was to turn all of our athletic photos in the hall upside down. As administrators and teachers laughed about this, it occurred to me that this was a fitting representation for what has been a topsy-turvy year. We started out in an online learning mode, transitioned to a hybrid learning mode, and finished with in-person learning. You have persevered through this craziness and are here today achieving the important milestone of graduating from high school. In spite of the challenges you have faced, this year will not be your worst or most challenging experience. You are just beginning the journey of adulting, and you will face many challenges along the way. You have had amazing teachers at Compass and gained many skills, such as writing essays, conducting science experiments, researching primary documents in history, and, of course, solving complex mathematical problems. Unfortunately, most of these skills will not help you when it comes to facing difficult life challenges. However, the skills you gained this year, thanks to COVID, such as transitioning between different learning modes and learning to endure things that you didn't like, such as wearing masks so you could attend school in person, will have all strengthened your grit. Through the pandemic, you have learned that there is always light at the end of the tunnel, but it requires a hopeful attitude and a lot of stick-to-itiveness. When you reflect on your senior year, consider the silver lining that this year's challenges have provided and apply the lessons learned when you are faced with challenges in the future. You have all demonstrated that you have what it takes to overcome roadblocks and find success. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Abigail Shaw.
And I am Ethan Shaw.
We welcome you to our graduation, and we really appreciate you being here to celebrate with us. We also want to thank the Board of Directors, administration, and our parents for making it possible for us to be graduating today.
Congratulations, class of 2021. Who would have thought that both me and my cousin Abigail would both be named salutatorians? But here we are. Graduation is a time of relief, accomplishment, and a little bit of nostalgia. So we wanted to quickly share some of the best moments that this amazing class has experienced over the last few years.
One day, to Mrs. Fletcher's complete surprise, Ponta answered her phone in the middle of math class.
One of my favorite memories was playing soccer with my friends outside. We played outside in the field behind the school at lunch every single day. All good things must come to an end, however, with Blaine sending an absolute rocket of a kick right into the middle of the freeway, an incoming semi-truck demolishing it.
We all know about the Compass dress code, but nothing will ever live up to when Taylor was sent home from pajama day for wearing a cow onesie because the udders were considered inappropriate.
Who could forget the Spanish market with everything from indulgences and instant water, just add water, for sale. I'm still upset that my Gucci carrots didn't sell very well, even though they were like 500 Kanye cash. I would walk out of that classroom with boxes and boxes filled with the talents of our classmates in the form of delicious sweets.
One day, a student had the hiccups in Mr. Baker's class, and when he tried to startle the hiccups out of the student, it sent the whole hallway into a soft lockdown.
And everyone in ecology will always remember Hayden writing an entire song about moats, just to prove that an ideal farm should in fact build a moat. To conclude, we wanted to express how proud we are of this class through pushing through and making the best out of this COVID situation. We've all grown so much and watched each other grow up. To quote Juice WRLD, as we go on, we remember all the times we spent together. As our lives change from whatever, we will still be friends forever. I leave you with this. Do what makes you happy and shoot for the stars. Never wake up one day with regret.
Here's to the class of 2021. Thank you.
Hi. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Elijah Mao. I am one of the three valedictorians this year. The other two are Lindy and Amanda. So guys, please feel free to blame them if this speech is boring, because they made me do it all by myself. I'm totally kidding. Please show these guys some love, and I just want to also recognize them for their hard work. And speaking of hard work, a huge shout out to the administration, staff, and teachers at Compass. I've been here since the sixth grade, and everyone here has been so friendly and just helpful. And I can really tell that they care about their students and the education that they're receiving. Teachers make or break a class, and I can tell you that just about every teacher that I've had has made class fun, pushed me to achieve more, and earned my respect. Initially, I was planning on writing out a list of things that I appreciated about all my different teachers through the years, but the list just got longer and longer and longer. Guys, you are all so unique and respectable in your own way, and I really appreciate you. So just know when I say that, I'm not talking about all the other teachers but you. I'm talking to you guys. All of you have taught me just as much, if not more, from your actions as you have from your coursework. Seriously, thank you guys for being good leaders. I and all of your other students can tell that you care. But teachers weren't the only thing that made high school special. It was all of my peers here. I actually think we have a really solid class. And seniors, thank you guys for making this journey epic. I will always remember playing soccer in the parking lot. Apparently I don't remember. But here, let me check. I'll always remember playing soccer in the parking lot. Fooling around in class and during stressful presentations. And that one time when Malia asked me why my face looks so weird in English class. I wasn't trying to make a weird face. Jokes aside, I've made some awesome memories with you guys, and thanks just for making high school great. I'd even go so far as to say that I wouldn't mind being forced to do a group project with any one of you guys. But teachers and students are the only people who have contributed to my high school experience. The people that came before us paved the way to this moment. How on earth would I know about atoms, genetic disorders, calculus, ancient history, and the orbits of celestial bodies if it had not been for the curious and hardworking people that came before us? These people were just as real as you and I are today, and it's amazing to live in the world that they have built for us. We are here because of the forgotten, curious minds, brave soldiers, upstanding freedom fighters, genius founding fathers, diligent first responders, humble pioneers, bright-eyed explorers, meticulous scientists, pondering philosophers, hardworking laborers, and honest average citizens. Seniors, now it's up to us to pave the way for future generations. Don't worry, I'm not talking about climate change. But the fact is that even though we are more technologically and medically advantaged than all of human history before us, we still struggle with the same problem that has plagued us for all of human history, human nature. Life is tough, and you and I are no strangers to difficult relationships, unmet expectations, broken promises, and food poisoning from Taco Bell. We can also be our own worst enemies in life sometimes when we procrastinate, cut corners, say things we wish we could take back, or choose to eat at Taco Bell. There's actually some really deep symbolism there if you look hard enough. But the point is that if we really want to make this world a better place, then we have to strive to make decisions that are good, to do things that are right, and to do things that are honorable. Sometimes we don't all agree on what good is, but I think we can all agree that kindness, responsibility, empathy, wisdom, humility, courage, hard work, loyalty, and love are things that make this world one worth living. Guys, we are something special. Fast cars and big houses are hollow and empty, but we have beating hearts that can bring warmth and life to the people and things around us. We can build each other up or tear each other down, so which will it be? I'm certainly still incredibly self-centered, but Lord willing, I'll learn to focus more on people around myself, because I can't imagine a better life than one spent serving other people. And I think in all of that way that you guys can go off and leave the world off better than where you started. So, it's the end of high school, but in a lot of ways, this is just the beginning. Congrats, guys.
I'm so excited that I get to announce the following speakers for our 2020 graduation ceremony. As a class, we got to vote on who we wanted to speak today. We picked individuals that had an impact on our class as a whole. Our class has known Mr. Watson and Mr. Baker for some time. Both of them had impacts on our education and our experiences throughout our Compass career. We were one of Mr. Watson's first classes when he taught here at Compass, and he had a strong impact on our education. With our small class size, Mr. Baker made it a priority to connect with individual students. Situations like these helped create an impact on our lives. So I am happy to see them both here today and announce our next speakers, Mr. Watson and Mr. Baker.
A little tight. It's good. So excited to be up here. You guys look amazing. It's so good to be able to see you, and it's an honor for us to be here. So thank you very much.
When we were upstairs, we got to kind of see the screen of where all of you are going, and we're proud of you, right? It's great.
Big time. One thing, it's been a bit since we've been able to connect. Mr. Watson, he's gotten grayer. I've gotten taller and more handsome.
I'm now an administrator, and he is still a science teacher, and I'm his boss. So I'll get some more gray hair soon.
That would explain the gray, that's for sure. So you're here in person. This is a challenge. Ms. Trudeau said it. Mao said it. It's been a long time coming, it seems like, to actually get us here in person. But here you are. Your generation's already been through a lot. You guys are the next step that's going to get all the other generations where they need to be because of what we've already been through, and you guys are going to be the forefront of it. So look at you. You're here in person. You're graduating. You're moving on to bigger and better things. For those of you that don't know us, we're going to do a little introduction for ourselves. I am Tom Baker. You don't know me my first name. Probably most of you didn't even know my first name. So. It's even strange to hear Hunt use Mr. with me. So it's just Baker for my last name. I came to Compass 7 years ago, taught here for five. I did some stints down in the Cherry Lane campus, teaching the elementary sciences, did high school sciences, did some health class. You're welcome for not having to sit through awkward puberty discussions and weird getting older discussions that we had. What Compass did for me, though, is Compass made me get it better every day. And so I appreciate you guys and the school itself very much.
And for me, I'm CJ Watson. About 5 years ago, I actually started as a first-year teacher with this class, right? So here at Compass, you actually are my very first class I taught. I was supposed to be teaching 8th and 10th grade social studies, and I do phrase it that way because when I started that, I was very bad at it. So, senior class of 2021, I apologize to you, your 8th grade year, it was rough.
Not true.
But each day, I was striving to get a little bit better, and this class helped me do that. When I taught you as 8th graders, and even more when I taught you as 10th graders. We have a friend, and that friend tells us all the time, each day you have a choice. You can get better or you can get worse. It's up to you. You always have that choice. And when I teach, I always love to do an activity with you guys and everybody. It's called Philosophical Chairs. And in this, I put out a statement. So I put out a statement, and then you choose a side based on whether you agree or disagree with that statement. So here are some examples. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, I'm going to try to get you guys involved, too. So we'll go light. Okay, Kit Kat or Reese's? So where are you at?
I am a Reese's guy.
Okay, why are you a Reese's guy?
I am a Reese's guy because chocolate and peanut butter. What could be better?
Kat. I'm Kit Kat, okay, because I like the crunch.
Okay? Yeah, I got you.
Raise your hand if you are a Reese's person, everybody involved. Ooh, I might have lost this
you
one.
Might,
okay.
Might,
Kit Kat, join me. Anybody? Thank you, people.
Way
all
to have
right.
courage. Way to have courage.
Appreciate that. Yep. They were just being nice to
yep.
me.
Yep.
Next one. Let's go summer or winter.
Summer guy. Sports. Gotta get out there and be active. Summer guy.
Winter guy. Sports. Okay. But different. Okay, raise your hand if you are summer. Summer, 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 classic. Okay, and then winter. Okay, I am the minority twice.
I don't think it's gonna last long.
All right, go for it.
I think cat or dog.
Okay, I am dog on this one because dogs, I mean, come on, let's be real.
Is it because you need the dogs to just worship you? Is that?
Yes.
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 Yeah. Cat person, they can just do whatever they want, go where they need to go. How many of you are a cat person? I'm gonna lose this one. Dog person, crushed.
In class, we did not ask these questions, but we asked more challenging questions, like, are humans good or evil? Okay, we talk about order versus chaos and what makes that, and we would have really good, deep discussions around it, especially with you guys. And what I loved about it is you would get mad at me in these conversations. Like, when I would ask, are humans good versus evil, you didn't want to choose a side, and you would always strive to go for the middle. Right, you would find the arguments and the nuance that goes in the middle, and knowing that things were never black and white, that nothing, for an example like that, is ultimately good or evil, right? There's a lot that happens within that. And this made me grow as a person because it forced me to have more challenging, nuanced discussions with each of you. It made me better as a teacher because I needed to raise my level of thinking and teaching to actually help you grow as individuals.
Absolutely. This graduating class forced me to get better every day because I had to raise my level to where you guys were, from where even I had come from in teaching, but more so about where you guys are already when you were in eighth grade or ninth grade, where you were, I had to try to reach where you guys were. I had to try to keep up with the intellect of a compass kid. Compass kid. I had to keep up with that because it was a real thing. I had to teach the top rather than to the middle or the low. I had to teach the top and bring the others with us to try to get to the top. If you're to follow the idea that the bell curve, when it comes to grades where most people are average, this bell curve theory could be blown apart by A, compass kids, but it could also be blown apart by the simple idea of trying to get better every day. And try a little harder and do something that's outside your box. Be an outlier. And I can see all of these things already just seeing you guys after a couple of years of being gone. Help make somebody else's day, make their day better. I had to try harder just to keep up with you, and you guys made me better. So thank you for that.
So congratulations to you guys. You've reached a milestone. After today, you all have plans that we were looking at. You have college, missions, travel, work, all these different things. And you will consistently have the opportunity to get better or to get worse. And while you have a current worldview based on your experiences, as you know, life is mostly lived in the nuance, in the gray area, and you have to constantly adapt and change. It's never black and white. And each of you will be in circumstances where you will have the choice. Will I get better in this moment or will I get worse? Continuously strive to get better, to learn, to grow, to further develop your worldview as you enter an incredibly complex world.
So congratulations, class of 2021. Thus far, you have navigated this world well. There's been hiccups, but you have gotten past them. We have full confidence that you'll do incredible things as you continue to navigate this world. And just like each of you, this world and all the things in it is also either getting better or getting worse. So take it upon yourself to make this world better a little every day. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Sorry, I wasn't reading my agenda. Board of Directors, I present to you the class of 2021. They have met the State Department of Education requirements and the requirements of Compass Honors High School. I submit this class to you as fully qualified to receive their diplomas.
Nathan Daniel Adolf. Catherine Rose Akers. This last name I struggle with a lot. So I'm going to say Ponta, and I'm going to let her come and tell you how it's pronounced. Ponta.
Hi, guys. Sorry for the hassle. So it's Ponta or Zamgin Hagigi. That's pretty much it.
Thank you, Ponta. Briley Grace Barnes. Ashlyn Michelle Bliss. Raiden William Bullock. Grace Isabel Burton. Audrey Jaden Butler. Hayden James Boyd Casanelli. Blaine Marcus Cordero. Colby Leonard Gutierrez Curzon. Hallie Madison Ellis. Jade Brooklyn Ellis. Madison Michelle Foss. Julia Gardner. Jesse Dakota Grover. Malia Kathleen Hammond. Holly Marie Harbison. Sydney Jordan Heyer. Grace Elizabeth Hug. Elizabeth Erin Hunt. Braden Daniel Irish. Isabella Margaret Jordan. Adita Kanichuk. Nathan Gray Kaler Overacre. Cassandra Ann Lashaway. Benjamin Anthony Lechner. Aiden Skyler Lutke. Dawson Scott Marbury. Mark J. Marlett. Elijah Eugene Mao. Emily Elizabeth Morris. Maxwell Isaac Rice. Amanda Ruth Ryle. Abigail Joe Shaw. Ethan McKay Shaw. Benjamin Craig Stark. Lindy Ann Thurgood. Daniel Edward Tolman. Savannah Jade Trickett. Preston Mitchell Weeby. Matthew Allen Williamson. Taylor Rose Wrigley. I present to you the class of 2021.